What's up, investors? My name is Artem Dikarev, and in a couple of minutes you will know what are junk bonds. I'll first give you a professional definition and then I'll explain it as easy as I can with examples. And if you want to learn personal finances and investing by watching such short videos, please consider subscribing to my channel, liking this video to show the support for the young creator. Many more videos are coming. Thank you so much and let's get straight to the point. Alright, so junk bonds are those type of securities that have the highest risks of default. Junk bonds are the opposite to investment grade type of bonds. And if you're not sure what an investment grade means, feel free to watch my previous video. And here is an example. As you might already know, bond securities have ratings. And these ratings show the likelihood of a company or a municipal to repay its debts. High ratings usually mean high safety but low returns, while low ratings show that a company might have difficulties repaying its debt holders. For such additional risks, companies have to make higher interest payments. That is why bonds with lower ratings usually have higher returns. And junk bonds are these type of securities with the lowest ratings as well as the highest yields. Investing in them implies higher risk of default from an issuer. And because of this, investors are compensated with higher returns. When companies find themselves in financial distress, they need to find money to overcome such difficulties. And one way of doing this is by issuing bonds. But because these companies are already in a very bad financial condition, rating agencies usually assign very low ratings to their bonds. And the reason for this is because they assume that a company will have difficulties repaying its debts. And this is how their bonds become junk bonds. Because of this, companies have to make high interest payments in order to attract potential investors. Investing in junk bonds can be risky. So, make sure to do your very own research before investing in them. Just extra couple of percentages of return might not be worth all the risks. And if you still have any questions after watching this video, feel free to leave a comment and I'll personally reply to you. Check my other videos to see if there's anything else you want to learn about personal finances and investing. Thank you all so much for spending this couple of minutes with me. I really hope there was something new that I learned today and it was straight to the point.